singer Whitney Houston, one of the greatest voices of our generation, CNN has gotten confirmation from her representative, has died.
The singer has died at the age of 48.
We are waiting to find out the cause of her death.
On February the 12th, 2012, at around 3 o'clock in the afternoon, Whitney Houston was found dead at the Beverly Hilton Hotel in Beverly Hills, California. Toxicologist reports claim that Whitney had died submerged in the bath in her luxury suite. The most likely cause of her death, a lethal cocktail of prescription drugs and alcohol. As speculation ran riot as to how she had died, fans gathered to pay their respects to the voice that had touched the world.
Bodyguard cemented Whitney's role really as an iconic legend. She is absolutely one of the most beautiful women you've ever seen, with a voice that could have been given from the angels.
The popular music historians will study Whitney Houston. And the perfect song to study is I Will Always Love You, because that is where she just went for it. Love you.
Oprah Winfrey described listening to Whitney as listening to the voice of God. Love
you. At that point, Whitney Houston had everything. You know, the movie itself was a phenomenal commercial success. The soundtrack was one of the best-selling records of any kind of all time.
I see the way that the media and the public in general responded to the death of Whitney Houston. The first response is to immediately a sadness, and also, on the plus side, a celebration of music.
And we'll just remember the genius that took her to the top of the world, and in posterity, we'll make sure she stays there.
The dazzling voice of a generation had been silenced forever. Amidst rumors of drug abuse, bisexuality, and a torrid marriage to hip-hop artist Bobby Brown.
No matter how bad or how ugly the rumors got about her life, a lot of people were shocked by it, you know, and just the fact that she was still a very, very young woman at the age of 48.
Few pop divas were gifted with a voice as glorious and sweeping as Whitney Houston, as she demonstrated in one of her most popular hits, The Greatest Love of All. They can't take away my dignity because the greatest love of all is happening to me. Her vocal range and charisma made her one of music's most glamorous and talented superstars. And she sold more records and received more awards than almost any other female pop star of the 20th century. The greatest love of all is easy to achieve.
In the case of Whitney Houston, her own personal life and problems are unimportant. What is important, because it is unique, is that she had the style which young women emulated for over a quarter of a century. That is amazing.